Hello viewers, my name is Evil Visions and welcome back to Katawa Shoujo. Look at that, I did a fucking intro without fucking up. Anyways, this video is most likely going to be a part of a marathon I got going on my channel. Most likely, at least I plan it to be. If I can't record the specific amount of videos I want to before July 25th, I believe, this video most likely won't be a part of that marathon. But still, it's, you know, a little marathon celebrating the day that I first uploaded a video. Then August 26th, that's the next month. After July, there'll be another little marathon celebrating the amount of time I've had my YouTube channel. Which I first created on, like, I believe 7 years ago on that day. Anyways, enough about the marathon talk. The stupidly named or brilliantly named, depending on who you ask. It is called the stick to, what was it again? I can't even remember what the name was, but it's gonna be in the description and it's kind of stupid. But it fits. Anyways. I can't find Shizune at first, but eventually she walks into the main part of the house, sipping a glass of ice water and dangling her glasses back and forth from her free hand. She whips them on as soon as she sees me. You didn't rescue Hideaki. That means you don't get bonus points. If you were also graded, hold on. If you were also being graded on style, I'd have to deduct points for being for a born escape. Already on to a great start with this one. It looked like you wanted to talk to me. I didn't know I had to be stylish about it. You know, some say the most stylish people are the ones that don't try hard to look cool. Yeah, therefore I am the most stylish person in history. I don't even fucking try. You're really cool. Something tells me she'd be sarcastic about it, huh? I wonder how it is that I can pick up on her sarcasm so easily, and how hard it might have been for her to learn the concept of sarcasm without being able to hear. I can't imagine it. I don't know. Yeah, but I'm just gonna ignore little things and continue on. Try not to get too sidetracked talking about random shit like I am now. You seem like you're in a good mood. Although I guess it isn't really a good mood. It's more like, or it's more that she seems very excited. I'm in a bad mood. Yeah, it definitely looks like it. Setting her drink down, Shizune sits on the couch. Also, I just realized something I should probably check just in case. Hold on. Okay, my volume is good. I liked her regular hairstyle so much more. It looks so pretty. It was refined and meticulous. I don't know. Now she looks too sporty and tomboyish. Don't call me she's refined and meticulous. I think that's the word. Whatever. That sounds more like you. You should give it a chance. Grow your hair out and make it look like drills. Actually, maybe this suits you just fine. Shizune rubs the frame of her glasses roughly, looking annoyed at the implications behind what I just signed to her. That's fine, because I was totally implying that. She Jesus Christ. She moves just a little closer to me when I take a seat. I'm a tomboy, but not really with the dress, at least. Hair kind of gives it away, kind of makes it look like that, at least. Also, hopefully, I can get all the videos recorded by fucking July 25th. Hopefully. Also, just a random side note, if you ever want to know what I do when I'm not recording fucking visual novel videos, check out my Twitch stream, just saying. Hint, hint, shameless self-plug. I can fucking promote myself whenever I want, though. It's my fucking channel. Well, no one will call you a tomboy based on appearances. She makes glares at me unamused. I have to fight to keep a straight face. Maybe you two should trade haircuts anyway. I don't think she's amused by this. You sound like my father, oh boy. Not that asshole. It's true. She's giggles noiselessly. Noiselessly, I couldn't say it for some reason. When she sees my displeasure at the realization. Jumping to her feet, she twirls an invisible sword in her left hand while standing up military straight and grimacing a terrifyingly accurate expression. Impression, whatever. Let me make sure I didn't just like fuck that up. Hold on. Yeah, impression. If it's impression, smart ass, there we go. Anyway, I don't take advice from anyone who wears a blue sweater with brown pants. What's your sense of color coordination? Dreadful. Just straight up fucking called him out with his goddamn sense of style there. Dude got no style, I guess. Yeah, fuck that guy. Dude seems like a prick. But change my haircut. That might be fun. Wouldn't it be? I want to see how everyone would react. I'm sorry, I suck at reading, don't I? Jesus. I just really like playing with people. Sometimes I think a little too much. No answer. The way she fiddles with her glasses, I'm pretty sure you can hear my nephew in the background. Ignore that. The way she fiddles with her glasses. Brow furrowed. I don't know why I had trouble saying that. Anyways, tells me that it's because she can't. I can't wait. I'm very off my game right now. Yeah, because she can't. I was gonna stream, to be honest, but I didn't really feel like it. And I'm a little somewhat tired, I guess, so. I'm not on my game, but I never am. It's fun. And with more confidence, and while pulling herself closer to me. What? Wait, what? No. It's fun to drag more and more people into my life. Ah, I see. I wonder if I'm included in that number. I want to ask, but I'm not even sure how I would. She's gonna wax a finger preemptively, indicating that she won't be answering such a question anyway. She reaches for a glass, but doesn't seem to realize how far she's managed to inch away from it all this time. Brr. What a cough. Prevent herself from tripping over clumsily, she tries to grab onto me and ends up pulling me on top of her. Really? Oh shit. We get some actual illustration shit like this. As I lean over her, I can feel the heat coming off her body and realize how close we are. I am trying to keep a straight face as I read this seriously, I'm sorry. I can hear soft breathing and the slight rustling of her clothes as she momentarily fidgets about. A blush starts to creep into her cheeks, but her eyes stare straight into mine, dark and unblinking. It's the first look. It feels so weird just reading shit like this out loud, but I'm gonna have to get used to it. 40 parts later and I'm still not used to it somehow, I don't know. It's the same look from the first time I saw her, piercing and devoid of any clear emotions. Just waiting to see what will happen next, like the eyes of a cat. Makes me feel uncomfortable being looked at in such a way. It's the first time I've been so close to her for an extended period of time, and the mood is different now. The situation isn't the same as a passing touch. My hands are her and Misha's usual games. She's in his fingers weave together tentatively. I don't know. But she makes no move to sign. The look in her eyes isn't just nothing. Isn't just nothing like I thought. It's more like expectation. I wonder if maybe I've been following the string of her expectations this entire time. Okay. Just roll on. And that never happened, clearly. I feel like you're grabbing me by the shoulders and then gently but firmly pushing me off of her. Why not just fucking violently push the motherfucker off you? Come on now. I roll sideways onto the soft couch and put myself into a sitting position less than a foot away from her. Less than a foot from her, not away. I always add my own words sometimes. The way I feel, she might as well have thrown me 10 yards. I'm hopeful at this, Jesus. When I think about it, this is perhaps one of the biggest drawbacks of sign language. She's nice at the fact that you have to sign your words out with your hands. Means you have no time to reflect. Means you have time to reflect on what you say before you say it. But on the other hand, it also means that what would normally just be an awkward silence becomes an insurmountable wall. I just blurt out something, anything to try to and dispel the tension. Jesus, I'm the best at this. I'm feeling right now, if I could, but I can't. Ordinarily, I think that would be normal. Hold on. What would be normal? I mean, fuck, I missed a word. What would be normal would be to apologize and then maybe leave. But right now, I wonder if that's even applicable. Fucking Christ. See, I need to look up some of these words sometimes and just fucking pronounce them correctly or something. I can't get past how guilty such an action would seem, like I was just slinking away. Of course, it's not like I just played off like nothing happened either. That would just be insulting to both of us. So, as much as I didn't want to, I apologize quickly so quickly I forget to sign it. Then I go back to my room. It just fucking walks away like, fuck it. Zion, I let myself fall backwards into bed. I wish I could just go to sleep right now, but I feel wide awake. Now I know that feeling. I can never get to fucking sleep, dude. Like, I can never get to sleep. Okay. What the fuck? Listen, alright, there's a thing called privacy. I need some sleep right now. Also that picture. Whose picture is that? I still don't know. Pretty sure you could hear that one clear as fucking day. I sit up when I hear the door closing and I open my eyes to see she's in there sitting in the chair in front of me. She asks a question that goes right over my head due to my surprise. It's not a feeling I'm good at concealing. I don't think it's what she intended. Whatever she was saying, she backs off and doesn't attempt to sign again for a while. Take a drink real quick. This is the first time I've been in your room. Well, congratulations. She's in a tense of fingers and puts on an exaggerated attempt to make herself look embarrassed and modest at the thought. I apologize for the background sound. There is nothing I can do about that, and I don't really mind. Anyways, I can't appreciate the joke, just the fact that she's here has me feeling a bit scattered. What's my volume at, by the way? Okay. Like, actual audio. I was wondering why, like, the music sounded so silent. Very funny. It isn't even my room, it's your guest room. Besides, you and me should watch in my room once before. Yeah, that did happen, didn't it? It seems as if she expects me to say more. I remember feeling very panicked when they burst into my room, afraid of what conclusions they would jump to seeing the wall of pills lying in the place. I don't think that she's any remembers, though. It made you nervous. Yeah, come on now. A bunch of people just burst in your fucking room. You're gonna be nervous, of course. So, well, what the fuck? Did I find a stash? Oh, shit. What? Anyways, the way she says it so factually stings me. I don't know. Some words get me confused sometimes. When one word is so close to another, it confuses me. In terms of how you pronounce it, I guess maybe, I don't know. Or how it's said, or how it's put, how it's spelled, whatever. Words in general confuse me. Everything confuses me, alright? Fuck it. A lot of things make me nervous. You're one of them. Was that an insult? You throwing down? We bringing the heat? What's happening? Because you're over-eager to always get people involved in whatever you're doing. Whether it's joining the student council, or even taking a break, whether they want to or not. Oh, did she get offended? I can't tell. Is he paying attention to this? Dude, come on now. Pay attention here, you're... This dude needs to fucking get back up on his goddamn sign language classes. This motherfucker, I can't read that. I don't know what's being said. Come on. You gotta translate this shit for me, buddy. Come on. Come on, game. Do it for me, please. She signs almost at a crawl. Her hands pause mid-sentence far too much, causing the words to dissipate formlessly before I can even begin to try to understand them. Fucking pay attention, dude. Come on now. I try not to let on that. This is the case. Hold on, wait. I try not to let on that this is the case. Fuck. My reading really makes these confusing for me sometimes. I don't know why. Just my random pauses in this. I'm not professional. Nor do I try to be. It seems to work, but she looks a little sad, and I regret that I have nothing to say to snap her from her strangely wistful and distant expression she's wearing. All I can do is wait for her to come out of it. Oh boy, I got my little stupid small ass desk way too fucking close to my chair. Anyways, you're right, I'm about to drag everyone into my life. My nephew's being loud, sorry about that. But lately, I am no longer sure if it's the right thing to do. I enjoyed you taking me to your favorite restaurant the other night. Wait, did I read that right? Fuck. I don't even know. I don't know why I didn't think I did. I just need to check. I overthink things sometimes, clearly. Okay, yeah. Okay, I did. It's not like that was my favorite restaurant. I have others I like. I might even be able to rank them by number. Really? She gonna start rating restaurants? This chair is so hard, I'm gonna sit on the bed. Motion her to go ahead, I wait for her to get off the chair and take her place when she does. Though I didn't intend for it to be, she finds it amusing. Close your eyes. I don't trust you. You're gonna fucking poison me. Why? It's a surprise. But then I can't read what you're saying. What? Come on now. Come on. What the fuck? I won't understand what she's saying if she says anything. I decide to humor her and close them. I can feel her leaning over me and suddenly something... What? Okay. And suddenly... Something soft and moist touches my lips. She's poisoning you, I can tell. My body tenses up in surprise, fortunately not as awkward a reaction as I could have made. It's just a quick peek. Just a quick, not peck, peek. Or it's peck, not peek, you jackass, come on. It was just a quick peck, not peek, you fucking moron. And I almost think that's the end of it. But then she kisses me again and more deeply this time. Yeah, I'm sure she's just poisoning you, dude. Come on now. Her hands slide onto my shoulders, up to my neck, and then back down again. across my shoulders and down my arms. Okay, this is getting like real descriptive here. We getting real descriptive. I mean, she's just poisoning the dude, right? Come on. I can feel the weight of her body on my legs and the eroticism. Fuck. I'm horrible at words. I need to study up on some words, goddammit. The eroticism, I guess. I don't know. Well, the situation isn't lost on me. At this point, I'm ready to try and open my eyes just a crack. But as if expecting it, she puts her finger on my eyelids. Seconds later, something ties my hands together at the wrists, and I panic. Not knowing what to make of this, my first thought is to ask she's made what she's thinking, even though she can't hear me. I'm sure she gets the gist of it. And just start talking. Talk to the deaf person, I'm sure it works. She won't let go of my hands, tracing her fingers over them from the lines of my palms, over my knuckles, into my wrists. Okay, well then. Suddenly this. I mean, Jesus Christ, it's got a hand, like, come on. All this because I fucking fell over? Because, okay. Hey, what are you doing? What's this? You say to the deaf person? Or, of course, with my hands tied behind my back, I might as well be gagged. Part of me can't help but think that this is what she intended. As if rude in my thoughts, a mischievous expression lights up her face. But her blushing doesn't fade. In fact, it only deepens when our eyes meet, and I can hear my nephew up there, nice, embarrassed. She leans deeper into our partial embrace, hiding her face by burying it into my shoulder and neck. This has gotten really, like, goddamn. I picked a really perfect time to record this, too. It's going up on the something load, I can't remember what I called it. I know I changed the name, like, 50 times, anyways. Her hair is soft and it tickles me, and I let out a laugh knowing that she won't hear me, won't be offended. She won't be, what? I don't know. Confused me for no reason. Shizune's hand moved towards down the fly of my pants, covered by hers. Okay, yeah, this is getting real intense all of a sudden. Covered by her skirt. Her hands disappear from view, only to jerk back. This has gotten so out of hand. Like, god damn. And this started just because of a fucking little trip over? Are you kidding me? I picked the perfect time to record this. Damn. Dude, I should've got fucking Jared or Bowen the one of this. Man, fuck. I'm sure Bo would be laughing it up right now. Oh, I should've got Jared, man. Fuck, I don't know. Yeah, this is a one-man operation. Anyways, only to jerk back on touching my erection. See, now, like, I am not gonna be able to keep a straight face. Like, I'm trying my hardest. It's not working. She's an almost falls off me from nervousness. It's like she didn't expect it to be there. Yeah, see, I can't read this with a straight face. What the fuck? God damn it. Do they expect me to? Like, whatever. Take a little breather or something. My nose get like stuffy as dicks. The sudden display of naivety is the starkest contrast to yet how forward she has been so far. And I find it amusing. Suddenly she seems very immature again. A high school girl playing the role of a more aggressive woman. Yeah, clearly she fucking tied you up, dude. Jesus. How do you expect me to, like, read this with a straight face and not burst out into a smile? Like, this got out of hand from, like, one little trip over. It was a fucking mistake, and this happens? Like, it's just like, I don't know. Was this supposed to happen? I mean, shit just went like from a fucking 0 to like 11. immediately. God damn, can I put this on YouTube? I may have to censor some stuff. I may actually have to start censoring stuff. I may have to, and I repeat, have to, put a fucking effort into this and censor shit. Not that I haven't edited things before, like in my 100th video special. But this may be the first time I gotta fucking actually sit down and edit this. And I'm alright with that, I'll fucking do it. The problem is I don't know how I'm gonna censor it. Like, I don't know how to edit things. I'm bad at that. This is confusing. Like this, that I wasn't prepared for this. I thought I had at least like maybe 10 more parts before something like this happened. Now I gotta fucking prepare for this. I gotta censor this shit. I'm gonna have to like to censor this to put this on YouTube. God damn it! I wasn't prepared for this. I'm pretty sure the dialogue alone here is gonna give me like fucking. Maybe for a fucking strike on YouTube or something. But then again, I swear all the fucking time, so I'm sure YouTube don't give a damn. Like, YouTube has to worry about a dude with like 14 subscribers swearing about him in his fucking channel. Anyways, let's get into this before I gotta, you know, start censoring some stuff eventually, because I feel like this continues the way I think it's gonna be. I'm gonna have to start censoring. I can't be a mature man, but just come on now. Be a mature man, Virgil. Fuck. Come on now. Be a mature. Be a mature adult. You can read this shit easily. She pokes at my penis curiously with her index finger, her face reddening as she runs the rest of her fingers down. I'm trying not to laugh. It's on underside. Still trying not to laugh. Her movements are soft and incurious. They feel the embarrassed look on her face. What? I don't know what that word is. That word threw me off there. It's likely she's as nervous as I am, so I'm a bit relieved when she stops. Her exploratory prodding. It's a weird way to put it. Is that what the kids are calling it nowadays? But then I think about what's next to come. She might try to unbutton my shirt. Who knows what she would say, seeing the scar on my chest. I'm still self-conscious about it, and I can imagine the concern on her face, seeing it. The tenting of her fingers and thought. Luckily, in this position, she couldn't take off my sweater without ripping it off me. The fear fades from my mind. Now I'm only experiencing a strange, uncomfortable mix of anticipation and nervousness. Still gonna have to start censoring shit, aren't I? A newfound lightness on my knees brings me back to reality. And I can see she's now standing on the tips of her toes to slide her underwear down her thighs. When she sees me looking at her, she tries to cover my eyes with one hand. Yeah, that's gonna work. Why not get a fucking blindfold or something? This goes through the trouble of fucking tying the... whatever. I wonder exactly when it was that I started being attracted to her. It's probably about the time of that, like, little festival thing, right? Probably. At least that's what I'm guessing. I don't know. Not just attracted to her physically, but drawn to her. And I wonder why. Yeah, I don't know either. I'm just along for the ride. I'm just a narrator. I'm just a goddamn narrator for this shit. She's pretty, but then also very combative. Fuck. See, I'm a horrible narrator, though. Not just dead, but she seems likely to... Fuck. She seems to like being that way. Get fucking rejected. I'm just thinking about the fact I'm gonna have to censor this, and that's what's throwing me off right now. I'm getting so lost in, like, thinking of how I'm gonna censor and what I'm gonna put there. And if what I put there should be put there in the first place. or if I should just find some random image from like Google Images and start pasting it all over the place and censor it, whatever. I need to stop thinking about that. I'll think about that after I'm done recording. The way she's acting now, however, and at other times, doesn't really fit that image. I'm starting to think that maybe her tying my hands might have been more for, might have been for more reasons than just the most obvious. Still, that aggressiveness that flashes around as comfortably as a business card is real. I don't know whether or not the kind of attitude could be considered dangerous. If it is, I wonder what kind of person that makes me. Smart guy, he's over here talking to the deaf again. It was probably the first week I was here. Week doesn't sound so long when I think about it, but at the time it did. I mean, when I record, a week is like a fucking month and year and fucking forever. Anyways, even though I pretty much thought my days were numbered that week, it still seemed to go by so slowly. Even if she can't hear me, it puts me at ease. I started to realize that I didn't have much to complain about, but there's still, well, never mind. She glances at me for no reason other than that I'm talking, because she can't understand what I'm saying. She suddenly becomes increasingly flustered, but doesn't sign anything in reply. She suddenly sucks in her breath sharply as she lowers herself. Why do I gotta laugh? God, be serious about this. This is an actual emotional thing that's happening in the story of this shit, and I gotta be a fucking narrator. And I gotta be a good one at that. Let me get my bearings together here. I fucking apologize to like anybody who's actually watched every single part of this entire series so far, because I have not been the most great art professional. But one thing will always remain for this series. Every route, everything, every goddamn line, I will fucking read it. And I will. It's gonna be an accomplishment for me. Let's take it from the top and not fucking laugh like an immature asshole, alright? Fucking Christ. This is serious emotional stuff. Development that is happening, and I am refusing to be in a professional man about it. I'm the narrator and for this series, and I need to fucking be one. His knee sucks in her breath sharply as she lowers herself onto my penis, trying to keep herself upright as she teeters on top of me. Don't you laugh, you son of a bitch. The skirt of her dress covers both of our intimate parts, and she traps her body heat under it like a tent. Under it, I feel unbearably hot, and Shizune's hand guided me into her only adds to it. It looks like I won't have to censor stuff, I guess. Maybe not. Who knows? I may have to, though. I think I'll censor it just to be safe. The second that I penetrate her, Shizune winces. I have to move a little bit. My arm or my leg is getting a little fucked. Then she nearly falls on top of me. The sudden sensation is mind-numbing, and I feel waves of pleasure radiate through me from both ends of my body. Gotta be a professional narrator here. Feels as if my entire lower body is enveloped in the warmth and wetness of Shizune's body. Very weird describing it, whatever. Able to feel every twitch and shudder as she starts moving. Do I have to censor this? I'm not sure if I do. Whatever. I think I may just to be safe. But then I think, I got time. I'll check. I don't know. Whatever. She begins rocking her hips back and forth, At first slowly, but with her tempo increasing each time, she pulls herself almost completely off of me. Only to plunge back down at the last second. Being so close to her, I can see the sweat beating on her skin, and don't you fuck with me, OBS, and the fog that forms on her glasses when they slide down her nose and too close to her mouth before she pushes them back up. Her fingertips press into my shoulders, holding on to them to steady herself, pushing against them to pull herself off of me, and then running down my arms and grasping for my wrists and hands as she pushes herself back down. Some really weird, like, oddly specific stuff to be describing, whatever. Maneuvering around like this is difficult at best. She tries to brace herself against me while pushing up herself up and down with her feet. I attempt to kiss her, but only manage to succeed in touching our foreheads together. At least, not painfully. Yeah, you know, at least not painfully. You know, that's a good thing to fucking... good thing to go on. Wait. Hold on, I'm like pausing for a moment here. I don't think I'm gonna edit that out, but I was a little distracted by something. Anyways, my thoughts wandered briefly to whether or not the door is locked. Hey, you know, fucking come on now. And if it were to open now, I'd probably have a heart attack, literally. And then there's the question of who would be opening the door. Oh, dude, if it was our dad, he'd be fucked. Like that dude, he would be fucked, dude. Dude's got a sword on him at all times. He fucks bears. He has business cards in his asshole. Dude would be fucked. The sense of danger only serves to make Shizune's movements more torturous. And I wish she would speed up before it. But from this position, it may not even be possible. Seriously, though, like if somebody just fucking opened the door, like, hey, how you guys doing? What the fuck? Just close it immediately. Like, I didn't see shit. That'd be fucking brilliant. I start moving my hips upwards in rhythm with her, trying to drive myself deeper into her. And it doesn't matter to me that my movements are shaking the chair. Dude, if you fucking, come on now. You're gonna fall over on the goddamn chair, dude, come on. It doesn't matter to me that my movements are shaking the chair we're on. Created a loud knock as the wooden chair wraps against the wooden floor. Dude, come on, you're being like loud as shit. Come on. What? What kind of noise is that? Her breathing grows louder and even sounds like suppressed moans to escape her throat. Though it's obvious that she wants to hold them in, they're still loud enough that they would be audible to anyone standing outside the door. Don't you want to bet like somebody's fucking just listening in on everything? What the fuck's what's going on in there? God, fuck. How much you want to... Is somebody actually going to be in there? I hope. It'd be fucking brilliant. I want to see what's going to happen after that. See, I still don't know if I got to censor this. Hold on. Do I? Is there like actual... I don't think there is. I think I'm going to, though, just for the... Wait. I think I'm going to, just to be safe, but there's no, like, nudity going on here. There's nothing, whatever. I stopped thrusting into Shizune, partly because it was hard to keep up with her as she starts getting more and more into it, and moving faster than I can manage to match well under her. Yeah, probably because you're tied to the chair, buddy. Uh-oh. My heart races so quickly that I can almost hear the blood pounding in my temples. Momentarily, I can feel a dull throb in my chest. I can't stop thinking about the pressure I feel between my thighs, if only for a moment. It's getting really, it's just gotten all fucking suddenly just woof. And this happened because of the fucking little trip up, Jesus Christ. Things got, just things escalated. That moment though was enough, combined with the tightness of her squeezing herself around me, and the sensation of her skin rubbing against me, I tense up, and oh boy, I tense up and fire off inside. She is in a fleeting feeling of power and flight. Oof. Dude, just win for it. What the fuck? Is there something flying in my face now? What the hell? Anyways. Afterwards, I listen to the sound of my heartbeat slowing down until it reaches its normal rhythm. I listen to the sound of Shizune's breathing as it does the same. So do I gotta sense or anything? I mean, nothing was really showing. I don't think I gotta. Whatever. My glasses are slightly askew. Fuck. And this is the first time she's been messing around with them in some way. I want to straighten them for her, but the second I try, I'm reminded that I can't. Yeah, you a fucking genius or something, dude? You're fucking tied to a chair and... Okay, whatever. She seems to have forgotten it as well. So do I get a sensor? I don't think I do, but... See, I don't know. I mean, nothing's being shown here. It's just being described, but I mean, there's nothing, whatever. Instead of getting up, she presses herself against me in the chair to extend her reach. It's almost as if the only position, if it's almost as if this is the only position she can think of to untie my hands from. This is what I think as I feel her unbinding my wrists. Excuse me. I silently burped, but still. However, she doesn't get off me, her fingers gently stroking against mine, occasionally bending inwards to run over my palms. It's funny, but I feel more connected to Shizune through this simple act than before. Jesus, man. I need to get like a real desk or something, fuck. Anyways. Shizune stays pressed. Fucking Christ. Shizune stays pressed against me like this for some fuck. I skipped it. I fucking skipped it. God damn it, hold on. I can't believe I skipped it. Shizune stays pressed against me like this for some time. It's a little uncomfortable, but it makes me feel happy. As if I could stay like this for hours. And now we go back to it. I skipped over that like an idiot there. Alright. So that was a thing that happened. They're just gonna pretend that never happened now? Is that what's gonna go on? The days since then have passed so quickly that time seemed to slip through my fingers like water. Every time I tried to talk with Shizune, she's been out running errands with with Misha. I feel as if she's avoided me. I'm not surprised, of course. It bothers me. But I think the way she's acting seems pretty natural. And again, it's not like I've been through this before. Yep, dude got laid for the first time right there. We just witnessed it, the first time in this series, Jesus Christ. It's the first out of, I assume, many, maybe? I'm pretty sure. Whenever I can't find Shizune, I end up running into Misha, and when I do ask her to help me with signing, I ask her to help me with signing. However, she always ends up squirming out of it. We're leaving after today, so I'm not determined to let her escape this time. What are you gonna fucking do what Shizune did to you now? What the hell? Once we head back to the school, probably not the last part, but maybe like the chair part at least. Once we head back to school, we're probably going to have to start grinding through more student council affairs in preparation for school restarted. I want to brush up on my signing as much as possible by then, even if it's just a day's worth. Dude, just like bring a book with you and start studying yourself or something. There's like a book for that, right? Yeah, there probably is. Come on, it's pretty much just a couple of sign language conversations. You do that all the time. Actually, you're doing it right now. Okay, I'm done. Really, John, it's funny. Yeah, do you know what else is funny? Your stupid shirt. It just temporarily stops your unconscious signing in order to wave her hands in front of her face in denial, but then quickly resumes gesturing everything the both of us are saying to no one in particular. It's just like a habit of hers now. I mean, I guess if you do something for long enough. Anyways, Hee-chan, you're so persistent. Yeah, you fucking teach me sign language, bitch. Please. Come on now. Suddenly being interested in sign language again. Could it be that Hee-chan wants to make a career out of it? Nah, fuck that. That's not fair. That was my idea first. Now I go ahead. Go ahead. I don't want to do this shit. You should be careful, Hee-chan. Times change too quickly. By the time I decided I wanted to be a sign language interpreter, they had cell phones that people could type out whole paragraphs on. Amazing. Not very good for me, though. Just get one of those sign... the phone, then do the sign language thing like that. Or can you not do... Oh, wait. Is it for the person? Never mind. Or is it... No, wait. How does it work? I'm confused. I got myself confused now. Whatever. I got myself confused from that. I got confused. What does the phone do? What is it? Can you get more explanation for that? I'm a little lost. Do I gotta look that up? Do I gotta Google that? Is there a manual for this game that tells me what that is? If so, where is it? And can I get it for research purposes? I don't know. Back to the fucking narration. Reading. Whatever. As if she knows... As if she knows about... hold on. Fuck. As if she knows that another deferral isn't going to cut it. This time? Wait, what? Whatever. Deferral. But I'm getting too confused now. Listen, that one scene just came out of nowhere. I wasn't prepared for it. And now I'm like, still like, what the hell? I'm still lost after all that. He should change his tune pretty quickly to a more apologetic one. I'm sorry, Hee-chan. I'm just so... Jesus, my voice just kind of died there halfway through. I'm sorry, Hee-chan. I'm just so tired. Especially lately, even though being with Hee-chan is fun, she has way more energy than me. Teaching on top of that would be too tiring. I don't have that much stamina. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. Whatever. She doesn't seem very tired of shouting that statement with her usual cheer and vigor. I know it's wrong of me to keep pestering her like this, though. And just keep on, come on. Keep on doing it till the bitch says yes. Actually, Hee-chan and I were... Whatever. Hee-chan and I were planning to go shopping today. It's our last chance to pick up some souvenirs. You better give me something, damn it. Come on, now. Souvenirs, huh? Almost forgot I was on vacation. I understand what you're saying. Teaching doesn't seem so easy. Hideaki asked me to teach him how to sign, and I was unbelievably lost the whole time. While I wonder how it'll work out for you when you become a sign language teacher. You can't get tired too easily doing that. You're right. Not you're right. Whatever. I hope not. If you want to be a fucking teacher, but then I get too tired, like, fucking easily. Sign one sentence. That's it for class. Later, guys. That's it for class later. I gotta go do something. Imagine if a teacher just did that. They came in. Alright, class, this is what we're gonna do. About, like, 10 minutes later, they're just like, yeah, I'm gonna go home. Later. Have fun. That'd be some fucking weird shit. Hee-chan, now I'm kind of worried. But souvenirs. What? Come on now. Just souvenirs over teaching, you bitch. So, some other time, Hee-chan. you bitch. What the? Like, come on. Dude, what? Are these souvenirs are so important? What is this? This is bullshit. Do you want us to get you something too? Maybe a book on sign language, maybe? Because you're clearly not gonna fuck it out. Just because I understand. Just because I understand doesn't mean I don't want her to teach me. I suppose I can't press her any further now, though. Even I'm bothered by how selfish it would seem to do, so I give up. Dude, get a book. Have them get you a book for the sign language. You can learn it yourself, you son of a bitch. I am waving my hands around like a fucking wacky, waveable, inflatable arm to me. Anyways, no. Don't give me anything. I'm serious. Don't surprise me with a funny shirt or something, okay? I mean, come on now. A funny shirt, though. You can have a shirt that says, I'm trying to think of like a funny I'm with shirt. Yeah, I don't know. Whatever. I don't like the sound of that. Swear to God, if I get a fuck, if this dude gets a stupid ass shirt, come on now. Just ask for a book, dude. You can learn yourself like that. You can just learn with the books. You learn with the books. You read the books. Come on. Slipping on her shoes, she yells goodbye to the otherwise empty house and opens the door to leave, letting a cool breath of fresh air into the hallway. A tuft of dark hair peeking from the doorframe tells me she's nice waiting for her outside. Good morning. You should translate that for me beyond the doorway. And she turns around to give me a small wave. Horrible like this, Jesus. Even though it's different from her usual offhand greetings in the smallest ways, there is an unmistakable hesitation there. It leaves me with a vaguely empty and distant feeling. Also, I just realized I've been recording for a long time. I don't know when to stop. Whatever. I'll stop soon. Or maybe I could just, like, stop it and then start recording again. You know what? I think I might do that instead. Do a quick little stop here, just so. But then again, I want this to round up to an hour. Yeah, I'll wait until it rounds up to an hour. Ow, my legs are like so uncomfortable with this tiny ass desk. Whatever. Hey, John, you're up early. Am I interrupting a conversation? Yeah, kind of, and I misclicked like outside the. Okay, there we go. I was trying to get Misha to teach me how to talk to you, but I guess I was being impatient, and it can wait. But you were planning on going shopping today anyway. Okay. Having Misha there, I forget to sign my words as I say them. Unfortunately, since she's moved to fill the doorway, Misha's behind her. This brief misalignment and opposition mean that what I'm saying is totally lost on her. I don't understand you at all. Stand in front of her, you bitch! You're sabotaging this whole operation! There are things I want to say that I can't put in a way that she will understand. And the entire conversations that she could have.
Okay, that was a sudden yawn. I'm sorry about that.
A sudden yawn interrupted me. Okay. In their entire conversations that she could have, that would go right over my head. And I want to tell her now that it won't be that way for much longer. That yawn really disrupted me. That yawn just came in and said, fuck you, the entire recording here. Instead, I just say, never mind, and tell them to have a good time and then wave them off. Seems like everyone is out for the day, so I sit on the biggest and most comfortable-looking chair in the living room with a book. Not a sign language book, one of those novels. But one of the novels I checked out of the library in my first week. Why not a sign language book, dude? Come on. You said you want to learn, but you're not even trying to learn. You asshole. That was so long ago. I should really start chipping at that pile of books I borrowed, or at least return them. Oh boy, this guy. 16 pages in, Jigoro. I guess I still don't know how to pronounce his name correctly. Whatever. Walks into the room, a stack of papers in one hand, and his sword twirling idly, like a baton in the other. Casually shaking water from a recent shower from his hair. Okay. Don't know why I had to reread that, but whatever. Upon being seen doing something so ungentlemanly. What? Ungentlemanly, I guess. I don't know why I can't pronounce that. He freezes like a deer in the headlights and slowly moves to smoldering with powerful but baseless fury as he sits down on the couch a few feet away. That yawn really fucking disrupted me for some reason. It's probably because I realize I'm kind of tired now, which kind of sucks, but whatever. This is only the third time I could have met him.
I'm out of it now.
I have no excuses other than I'm out of it. Anyways, this is only the third time I've met him, and I'm already starting to feel nauseous on reaction. I guess in a way, this could be considered a kind of charisma. I don't know why, but whatever. Dialogue confuses me sometimes in this. I don't know why. I haven't even said anything, and he already seems less than pleased. It's likely a bad idea to provoke him, and just talking to him may count as provoking him. However, I can't help thinking of an alternative situations that could play out. Let's say I don't open my mouth at all and walk away. Maybe to go read my room or outside. That would definitely go down as an unforgivable insult. He would probably tell me to hold it and destroy me. Yeah, you could take him. Dude's only got a sword. Fuck this guy. Either way, it's not too polite on my part. What are you reading? The draft from my autobiography. It's the story of a man who wakes up to find an uninvited guest in his living room, sitting in his chair and reading shallow literary dreck. Really? So this is an interesting piece. Did I mention how you're a fucking asshole? Or is that, not in the autobiography? Well, whatever. I barely started reading the book, and I don't have an opinion on it yet. I can already see how this conversation is going to play out. So I might as well try to steer it in a different direction. Where's Hideaki? He even asked questions rudely. Disgraceful. That aside, would you even ask me such... Why would you even ask me a stupid question? How would I know? Am I my son's keeper? I guess. Well, he was dead, and it seems like he does live here, so... But I guess I can't say that, tempting as it is. I give up. I already tried to make small talk with him and failed. It's like trying to talk to a brick wall that also hates you. Imagine just talking and a brick wall is just like, "Hey, fuck you, dude." What an asshole. That is my cue to leave and sift through my wallet to see if I have any money to go to a movie. Yeah, just fuck this dude. Go to see a movie. Go see some shitty goddamn fucking $1 movie. Better than talking to this prick. As I'm about to stand, I have second thoughts. I'm too tired to go through trying to smooth over my problematic situations by trying to continuously walk away from them. Come on, though. A cheap-ass dollar movie. You could probably get some few cheap laughs out of that. It's hypocritical of me to get upset at Misha for trying to differ things when I'm...
when I run away from my own girlfriend. Wait, what? When did he get a girlfriend? Or is she referring to, wait, what? See, now I'm confused here. That came out of nowhere. Is he just saying that? Hold on. Where did this happen? Somebody point me in the direction of why he said this and why. Eh, whatever. See, that's weird. Like, what? It's hypocritical of me to get upset at Misha for trying to differ things when I even run away from my own girlfriend. What does he mean by that? Does it mean she's an A or does it mean some other bitch? I don't remember. See, I may have just forgotten about something. I record these far too apart for, like, me to remember shit. Like, if I record one thing, I'm most likely gonna record the next, like, a few months or weeks later. So I must have forgotten something. Or he's just saying that, I don't know. When Jigoro attempts to stop me, I'm almost glad, even though I no longer have any intention to leave. Wait. He says it with plenty of authority, but nothing else. It's as if he's a particularly commanding afterthought. It's almost as if it's just a particularly commanding afterthought. Let me reread that there, sorry about that. Had to for the hell of it. Only a very powerful or very arrogant person can tell someone to hold on in such a matter. I'm sort of impressed. He's kind of an asshole. You're in the student council with Shizune, aren't you? What is your job there? Dude, do you not know what that is? Come on now. I don't think there are specific roles other than president. Shizune is always trying to round up people to help out there. Or help out here and there, I mean. Usually we get like one person to pitch in. But otherwise the three of us do whatever needs to be done. It's crossed my mind a couple of times. Around when I first met her, that Shizune is disquietly. Fuck, I don't know. My goddamn nose got like stuffy on me there. Whatever. I don't care what that word is. I'm tired and I don't care at this point. Analytics down might be because of her deafness, but it turns out it's a trait shared by everyone else in our family. And is that okay with you? Why wouldn't it be? You, Shizune, and that pink-haired girl? Is that really your entire student council? Yeah, pretty much, dude. With the student council that small, they wouldn't even bother to hold elections. And I'm going to take a guess and say that you don't even join the student council, or Shizune drafted you into it. You say you don't know exactly what your title is. Yeah, he's kind of right on that, though. That makes sense. I suppose if you were even elected, you couldn't be expected to know. After all, if you're not elected, you aren't really anything. No one is going to respect a student council like that. An unelected body of three people trying to scrounge up the equivalent of temp workers. Must be a sorry school if three kids having a tea party can handle every issue. Okay, you're being an asshole, buddy. Come on now. What's how small it is have to do with anything? If the student council gets things done, isn't that enough? It's not just a game either. Maybe you should actually come to school one day. If you get there on right days, you might even be able to see what Shizune is able to accomplish. Oof. Dude's getting some antsy. He's fighting back. Bring it, motherfucker. Let's fight. Let's do it. Come on. Fight me. Hit me. Seriously, I'm fucking tired. Hit me. Do you think I had that much free time that I could afford to waltz over to your boondocks and watch my daughter's feats of self? Okay, what is that even word? I've never seen that word. I've legitimately never seen that word before. Self-aggrandizement? What is that? I've never seen that word before. Am I just stupid or have I just, I don't know, whatever. I'm tired, and now I'm just like, I don't know. That's my excuse now. I'm actually tired. I've never been more disgusted in my life. Really. But you look in the mirror every day, don't you? What do you mean you've never been so more disgusted? Come on, buddy. You look in the mirror, don't you? Pfft, come on, dude. What you're saying is you might as well not have a student council, but the fact remains there is one. And she's in that got elected to it. And for her, it is a meaningless position. Fuck. In fact, she works very hard for it. You sound like someone who voted for her. Yeah, I don't think I had a cut in that at all. No, I wasn't there for that. Ha. You didn't even vote for her. Well, besides that, why don't you ask Hideaki about this? She said I has wanted to be a high school student council president since middle school. She wouldn't have him read all her practice speeches. Wasting his time for what reason? I'm getting like, fuck. Let me reread that. She would have him read all her practice speeches. Wasting his time. For what reason? Had to reread that just because I was confused for no reason. This whole time he wasn't even looked up from thumbing through his manuscript. It's getting increasingly frustrating. Hey, you know what? I think I might like stop right here because I'm getting like, foof, you know, getting like fucking tired here, buddy. You know what, I recorded that like May, it's like nearly July now. Okay, I'll just like do that. And I'm just gonna go back to the main menu cause like, I'm starting to just like lose it halfway here. Anyways, thank you for watching, and if you're watching this on July 25th, you're most likely going to be bombarded with videos on that day. And if you're watching this after July 25th, congratulations, you get a gold sticker. A gold sticker that says, I witnessed a great load of 2017. You need a sticker like that, I don't know. I'm done. I'm gonna get some sleep or something. Although, I don't know, I probably won't. Yeah, I probably won't. My sleep schedule's gonna suffer from this, fuck.